Even though the topic is called rules of differentiation, okay, I want you to cross out rules. And I want you to replace it with the word shortcuts. Because chain rule, product rule, quotient rule, and then all these different things for the different kinds of functions we've been looking at, they're not really rules in the sense of, well, when I think of rules, I think of sports. And like, I coach touch football, right? And rules are really arbitrary. They're totally, like, in many ways, they're very random. Because it's kind of like, well, just what makes for a good game? So it's like, in a full set, in a full game, a full cycle for touch football, it's 6 touches. But why is it 6? Like, why is that the rule? And the answer is, because some guy decided it would be a good number. Like, well, yeah, I don't know. It's just, it's arbitrary, is my point. Okay, someone decided it, and you just have to learn it, because tough, those are the rules of the game, okay? But differentiation rules are quite different. We've been looking at first principles, and then we've been looking at, okay, after you do first principles, what kind of principle do you see that we can sort of take advantage of? What kind of patterns are there that we can manipulate, okay? So really, these are shortcuts for how to differentiate things without always going back to first principles, okay? So that's the mindset that I want you to have. This is the table you should have drawn. 3 columns. The first one will be function. So we'll look at all the different kinds of families of functions that we've got. Then we'll look at the shortcut for how to differentiate. Okay. Now, I hope by now, most of this will be sort of starting to soak its way into your head. Okay. Then we'll have a look at how the shortcut works when you've got a function or a function you have to use chain rule, or chain shortcut, if you like. Okay. So, let's start. What was the very first kind of function we learned how to differentiate? Yeah, that's right. So the name that I would give that is either it's something raised to a power, okay? Or you have a whole string of them, and we would call them polynomials. Okay? So in each case, I'm going to name the shortcut, and I'll do it in general terms, and then I'll give you an actual example of it, and I'll try and fit it all in. Okay? So, if I am differentiating something raised to a power, right? X to the n. Okay, we've been doing this for a few weeks now. What's the shortcut? Nx to the n minus 1. Okay, good. So, for example, okay, let's differentiate, say, x to the 5. Okay, so the n is 5, so you're just going to have nx to the n minus 1. That's it. Okay.
So, can I just get it?
Yeah, of course. Do you want this? What do you want?
The first time you eat, you're going to be on YouTube.
Oh yes, you're famous. There you go. Childish. Okay. Now, by the way, let's just remember what you would have had to have done at this point here if we didn't have this shortcut. We didn't know this rule, right? You'd have to go first principles, limit as f, as h approaches 0 of f, blah, 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 and then you have this monstrous thing you have to expand and simplify. This really is a shortcut, right? A very, very much shortcut. Okay, chain rule. Suppose you're differentiating a whole function that's been raised to a power. So, there's a function in there that's raised to a power. Okay, what do you get? Well, the whole idea of chain rule is you differentiate the inside, and then you do the outside, okay? So the inside function here is just f. Stepping on this stuff. So the inside derivative is just f dash. Okay? F dash, and then you proceed to do the outside, which is just the same as it was before. Right? So it's f dash multiplied by n times f of x to the power of n minus 1. Just like you did before. Okay? Now, by the way, for most of this, I'm going to use the dot as my replacement for multiplication rather than a cross. Because I've got so many x's flying around, I just don't want it to be ambiguous. Okay, so watch for the, maybe I'll make it a bit bigger. That's a dot there. Okay. Alright, so let's quickly do an example. Sorry, there we go. For instance, let's take a function. Say x squared minus 3x. And if that was raised to a power, like say 10. And I was taking the derivative of that, okay? Differentiate the inside. The inside function is x squared minus 3x, so its derivative is 2x minus 3, right? Okay, So there's my inside, now do my outside. So there's a 10 down here, and then you reduce the power by 1. X squared minus 3x. And I suppose to be neater, we probably ought to put that 10 at the front, but we've done the differentiating. Okay, so I'm happy with that. Okay, there's the first one in my blue. Roll it off. Okay, now, after this we learned like product rule and quotient rule, that kind of thing. I'm not really going to include that here because they're not different kinds of functions, okay? So the next kind of family of different things we learned to differentiate was trig, right? So trigonometry. Okay, so there are three basic trig functions, right? And we'll do each one in turn. The derivative of sine x is the very first one we did from first principles, and the result we got was?
Cosine.
Okay, differentiate cos, and you get a very similar result, but not quite, it's upside down. Okay, and then if you differentiate tan, this is really just sine on cos. So we use the quotient rule, and we ended up with sec squared. Okay, good. So now when we carry over to chain rule, right? If I differentiate sine of a function, what's going to happen? Okay, hopefully by the time I get to the end of this table, you'll be sick to death of me saying this, but differentiate the inside, right? Which is just f dash. Okay, and then you differentiate the outside. So, cos of, because sine turns into cosine. Okay, then we do it for cos. Okay, again, there's going to be an f dash out the front, but I'll leave a little bit of space because I know that cos differentiates into minus sine, so I'll slap that minus out the front there. Okay, sine of. Okay, and lastly, tan of the function. Differentiate the inside, and then differentiate the outside, which turns into sec squared, right? Okay, so let's do a really quick example, shall we? Which one should we pick? Let's do cosine. Okay, fine, sine, let's do sine. Just so everyone always does sine because the basic one, but that's fine, we'll go with it, okay? So this is an example, okay? If I were to differentiate, let's see here, let's go sine of x. We had x to the 5, didn't we? Yeah, let's check that in. Okay. So, differentiate the inside, which gives you 5x to the 4. And then you do the outside. Sine turns into cosine.
Oh, that's not chain rule works.
Okay. See? Inside, outside. Inside, outside. There's all the trig functions, okay? I could give you more examples for cos and tan, but you get the idea. Also, yeah, that's nine. Also, from here, right? Oops, sorry. Just deleted that. From here, you can also get the results for, and this was on one of the sheets I gave you, right? Wrong one. The reciprocal function for sine is cosec, right? And you might have gotten this result, cosec cot. Okay. You can just treat it as sine x to the power of minus 1, and then go ahead and do chain rule. You can also see that the derivative of sec is sec tan, okay, and the derivative of cot is negative cosec squared, okay? After a while using these, like, you know, I'm sort of 11 years up on you, so that's a bit of an unfair advantage, but you'll start to get used to them after you do it for a while, okay? So, trigonometry, okay, then you can rule off. Most recently, we've kind of learned two new families of functions. They're flip sides of each other's, right? First, we did exponentials. Okay? And there were two cases that we were interested in. Number one, when you've got something to the power of x, and the something's any constant you like. Okay? So we said the derivative of a to the x, where a is a constant. I'm going to put that on the end. Okay? Is equal to, do you remember? What did we get for first principles? We used the computer to help us. It's a to the x times log a, which was this weird thing. We'll use the spreadsheet to help us pin down the number, okay? So this is the derivative where A is some constant, okay? Then we had the special case where A was our special number E, right? So the derivative of E to the X, okay, is just
E to the X.
All right, so some examples, right?
I'm going to not really worry about the constant one because it's not that important.
Let's look at this e to the x, okay? If I've got e to the power of a function, okay? Your inside-outside idea starts to break down because it's like, oh, this is inside and this is inside, but this is not inside, it's above, okay? But we're still calling it the inside function. It's still a function of a function, okay? So if my inside function is f, then I do the inside, which is f dash. Then you do the outside, which is e to the power of whatever, which doesn't change, right? So it's still e to the power of whatever, okay? So let's throw some shape functions in here since I've established that result. For instance, the derivative of e to the sine x.
E to the sine x,
okay? So I differentiate the inside. The inside is sine, right? So what comes out the front, the f dash, is just cos. Yeah, see that? And now differentiate the outside, which is e to the power of something which doesn't change. That's what I just established, right? So this will be e to the sine x. Okay.
Is this
in
the video? Is
from Friday? Yeah, it is. Should be. Okay. That's exponentials. I can multiply a few more examples if you like, but do we get the idea? Okay. All right, last one. I just managed to fit it on my board. Don't know how your page is going. What was the last family of functions? Logs, right? Okay, so if we differentiate the natural log of x, okay, what do you get? Do you remember? 1 over x. Right? Now, by the way, if I wanted to differentiate something and it had a different base, okay, say the derivative of log base 2 of x, what could I do with it? Okay, so because I want to get things into the base that's, you know, nice and neat, namely base e, I'm going to change the base here, right? So I'm going to say, well, this is the same as differentiating if I change it to base e. Right? What would it look like? Well, that base is on the top, and it's going to be on the bottom as well. Okay. Now, this really is the derivative of 1 over log 2 times log x. 1 over log 2, I know it looks weird, but it's still just a number, right? It's 1 over 0.69 over whatever we got. Okay. So this is going to be 1 over log 2 times 1 over x. So not that hard. Alright, so now, chain rule. If you've got log of some function, any function, whatever, okay? This is the last one. Start with the inside. So it's going to be f dash, right? Now, you do the outside, so multiply by 1 over whatever your function is. But since I'm multiplying by 1 over, that's the same as dividing, right? So, a shorthand way of writing this particular chain rule is f dash on f. Okay, does that make sense? So, example, let's differentiate log of, let's see here. What shall we pick? Let's just go back to a polynomial, because I haven't done one of those for a while. Let's do x squared minus 1. Okay, so the inside function is just f. Okay, so if f dash here is 2x, right? And then you divide by f. Ta-da! Not too hard. Okay. Alright, stand back and marvel. So that's it. Not including product and quotient chain rule, which is sort of included in this, okay? These are all the kinds of things you need to differentiate. All the different kinds of functions. These are all of the shortcuts you need to remember, okay? After this, where calculus, the topic goes is, well, this is nice. I can sort of machine my way through rules and do the exercises, but what's the point? What difference does it make when you know the derivative of something, and particularly when you're graphing things, okay? And that's what we'll move on to after this topic. Okay.